And the last most important thing you have to do now is to, for the course administration, is to add useful blocks, and maybe you want to remove some blocks, default blocks that is not necessary. So if you log into your Smart UMS, so all this panel that you see, okay, is blocks. Okay. So this block can be removed. Some of the block can be removed. Okay, but the navigation block and also the administration block cannot be removed, but can be hide. And there are more block can be added. So what you need to do is to turn editing on. Just click on the turn editing on. After that, you will see at the bottom of the administrations, okay, you can see add a block window pop-up, okay, and then just click on the add. Okay, then you can list off the block. Okay, so you don't have to add everything because otherwise your patch will be overcrowded. So all the block that you add into the course will be seen by the student and can be used by the students. So there are a few blocks is very useful that I recommend you to make it available for you and students. So first is activity, second message, progress bar, and session link. So we're going to discuss very briefly what is each of these is all about. So for activity blocks, so when you have your activity blocks, so all the material or learning content that you have in your Smart UMS can be accessed easily. So this is like a shortcut. So when you have this window, when you click on the assignment, okay, then it will show you the list of the assignment. Okay, and you also can do some customization here to set the due date, okay, as a teacher. For students, they can see clearly the list of the assignment and also the due date. Okay, similarly for the forum. Okay. So this is handy for you and student. And the other one that I showed you just now is a progress bar. So this is where you can monitor the student progress. And this can be seen by the student as well. So they can monitor their own progress as well. And the message block, okay, for you to manage the message. And also the session link. So this is a shortcut link for each of the week or session. So student can, or you can jump in any of these sessions, just click on by clicking on this. Okay, so these are the blocks that you have to add. At the same time, you might want to customize the block, or you want to remove or change the location of the blocks. So you can just click on this icon, setting icon. Okay. So for example, for navigation and administration block, you cannot remove it. So when you click on this icon, you can only see configured navigation block. On the other hand, the other block that you can add and remove, okay, when you click on the setting button, so this is all you can see, so you can hide the block, okay, or you can delete the block, okay. So it's up to the lecturer whether you want to keep the default blocks, okay. So I'm going to show you how to do it in Smart UMS. So remember, first thing first, make sure turn editing on. Go to the bottom. So this one I have something already. Okay. So you can add block, so activity. I want to add activity, just click on it. Okay. So I only have forum, so they show only forum. And I also want to add progress bar. Okay, my progress bar was already here. Okay, progress bar. Message is here already as well. Okay. And then next one is session link. Okay, so the search forum, maybe I just want to remove it. It's not necessary for the student to use it or for me to use it. Just delete. Okay, yes. Okay, upcoming event, maybe I just remove it. It's not necessary. Later news, don't need this one. So recent activity, maybe I leave it here. Online user, yeah, maybe I also don't need this one. I also don't need the calendar, just remove the calendar. Okay, summary. I also don't need the summary of the course. Just remove it. So this is more or less that I needed. Okay. Status completion, I don't need. So what I have now is a message, progress bar. So no worry about this. We will come back to this later. Okay, after you have set up your course total fully. Activities and session link. So this is how you can add and remove the blocks. For the customized setting, detail setting for each of the block will be discussed later. Okay, not in this quick start guide.